When I first met Jim Couch, I thought he was a talented water engineer, fully capable of doing lawn sprinkler systems and perhaps even larger pipes. Of course, he since has done very large pipes.
I think I met him on his first day of work at the city in 1987. He seemed young, but he seemed very capable and excited to be with Oklahoma City.
I don't think you can underestimate Jim's impact because, you know, a city manager is hit with a lot of opinions and they have a lot of responsibilities, and ultimately they answer to 9 elected officials. I mean, that's a really tight squeeze for anyone.
Jim is obviously our longest serving city manager by a lot. You know, I mean, he like doubled the record. But this was not a boring 18 years. You know, this is one of the most memorable 2-decade runs that this city's ever had.
Jim's legacy as city manager was, this was an era of absolute honesty in city government.
His impact on Oklahoma City will be that he was the leader of the MAPS programs that got things done, that got projects completed, that overcame some pretty daunting hurdles early on in the program.
Jim did such a good job of fulfilling the vision of the council and ultimately the voters of Oklahoma City that, you know, he gets an A+ in every category that you might want to grade.
And just every time that there was some challenge, he rose to the occasion. Who would have thought 30 years ago that you might turn to a water director to negotiate, you know, a lease with 2 different NBA teams?
And this is perhaps, I think, the real key to his success is Jim Couch is a decision maker.
Long-term impact will be these wonderful projects that everybody can enjoy. And, you know, with MAPS 3, we're just now beginning to see, you know, some of the really big impact projects like the park being completed, the streetcar now underway, and, you know, soon to be the convention center. So I think those are the things that will be around for a long, long time. And without his leadership, I'm not sure they would have been possible.
Yeah, I want to be in the room where it happens, the room where it happens. Okay. But the first part, did you catch that first part? It says, I want to build something that's going to outlast me. Shouldn't we all try to do that? Shouldn't that be our goal?